Hi, and welcome back to our Open Stop Motion film project. I was just getting the printer running while I run into a little trouble. So I will go and get it. The software crashed, so I will go and put it to work now. Just a second. I was just thinking that I could do it before, but then the software crashed, and then I had to start all over again, load and slice and whatnot. So, but as you can see, I have been down and bought some wood so we could get some of all of this glued together as grease. So that's what we are gonna do. And but the printer has to heat and slice and whatnot before we can use it. I have cut all these up in different lengths, and we will use hot glue to put them on so it goes reasonably fast. But you know, when you cut, you always get these kind of splints like this. So I tried to adjust the printer so you could get some better prints. We have a lot of work, as you saw yesterday, on them afterwards. So because there's a lot of threads and not on them. So we want it all to go as smooth as possible. So we can get so much done as possible. tree sticks a little bigger than the other ones, a little thicker. So because they are, or these as like this over behind. So you will do that on if this is hot. Oopsie. That steamy hot, but hot. Well. It's too late. Kinda. And a top on it. And here you can see why I gave the other ones plastic padding. Because we have this hard shoulder here. You don't want that much. Cleaning too, because this is not that. Because when I made all of these, I ran out of 22 millimeters, so I had to buy some more, but I also knew that I had to buy two of the others, and they are 19 millimeters. So but instead of sit and sand all of them down to or weld them down, and you can see it's not the exact same height as the other one because I have changed this little height, so we get a little difference. I'll just go to the printer a moment. I will not set the camera over there on, because when I move it in a little while, I saw yesterday I moved the camera while it was on and it's kind of seasicking. So how this is gonna go, because this is a whole new adjustment. Here it is. We'll see when we get so far. Until now it's just running. So and and how we can, and then we will mix these so that kind of what we get. First we will use don't get the same type and the same, not get the same height. So we will take these over here so we can reach, not those. What is this? It's nothing to do with this. It's the other one. We have a lot more. In a box, in a box over here. But first we can take this one and do these. And then we can take all the other ones. So, these. Not gonna use this time. Okay. We have a whole box here full of it too. It has been one chasing around all day. There was a lot of stuff I had to go by. Different things. Ready for the kids' workshop on Monday. So, you know, you always think you have a lot of time, but actually, you never have. It's easier to cut one of these than it is to print one of these. Oh. Faster, at least. I need to put some outlet, power outlet, up under the table here because right now it looks like we are building cactus from Arizona or somewhere. Would be able to tell us what kind it looked most like. It makes some pretty beautiful pictures from the desert there. All the animals and plants. Very different in comparison to what we have here in my country. Well, I guess everything has its own beauty. Beautiful in its own way. Not good. more careful. Where we stick it. Don't. I got it. I got it just. Just before it dropped down. out. We need some more ammo. Make sure. That was the wrong top to the wrong button. What do we care? This feels have been on this one. Thank you. fix this one here afterwards. He wanted to do that. Kind of hot. Maybe that's why they call it hot glue. It's a weird forest with neon green trees, kind of. Plastic top and plastic button. But the stop in the middle is right. Wood. Like it. Oops, I heard something bad. Maybe not. I'll go and take a look. I can hear when it hits, but it stopped again. We have a problem with this one. I don't know why. Everything looks okay. But it don't. Grab it. Now it Why is it? I can't place it on the middle. That shouldn't be that hard. Shouldn't be that hard. You can see when we first get them put together, there is not that many. It don't cover that big an area. But I can see one thing. I need to cut some more on those. See, now it don't take again. Hey. I think we need to buy a new one. This is not good. Every other time it will. Do The forest is growing, but not much, but it is. Growing anyway. And we have a whole box of those who are on the way back. True. Something. But it's always like that. You have to make a lot of preparation before anything starts to look at anything. Whatever you, if you are starting to renovate a car or a home or whatever your interest is if you start to tear down a room and start to build, take a long time before it starts to look. Like you wanted to. When it's all the worst, you think, I will never be finished with this. I just make kitchen and bathroom. Granny's place, and when you start to take all the element down and crowbars and big tools, then it don't look nice for a while. And I could look at her and see, she was kind of, is this gonna end well? But now she's very happy for her new beautiful kitchen. It's all like that, yes. I need some tops. I have some tops. And you sometimes see those car repair guys, those who restore cars, and they have a rusty car with rats in the seat and the motor is really bad to look at. And then after a while, start to look really nice. And one thinks, how did they do that? Mm-hmm. I have a little soft spot, of course, even here. So I often see those shows where buy old junkers like that and then fix them up. Both in England and US they have a lot of these shows. Or maybe not, but there is some. Find it fascinating to watch. I have more tops and bottoms, but no in between anymore. So maybe we need to do some of those. So we can get the last fixed. There we go. Six and eight and nine. Kind of look like a spring forest, you know, with a little good imagination. I guess you need that. They just did it print. This is the biggest one I made here. So if we made 9 on 18, we will do that. I will just set the camera up in there. So that, I think it is this one. So I will go and make someone eat you. It's not that accurate, just ungefähr. As my German friend would have said. I need to move the camera a little. Thank you. Oops. Six. Then we need one more. Two, three, six. One more. And a stick. Oh, maybe. So, not anymore. We put one on the floor, so we'll fix that up. I will, before we start, I will take a look. Understand what's going on. I have trouble with the print all the time. See, it stopped. And all these, like it's too hot. I cannot figure it out. I've not been able to print in several days now. Every time it starts very fine. And that's what I don't understand. Oh, there was something there, but otherwise it starts very, very fine. And then I get some very peculiar. Can be a bit frustrating, I'm telling you. I want some more coffee. But it cannot help start yelling and swearing and whatnot. That's what I would do right now. If I should follow my emotions. Is thank you. I think this one is way much thicker than this one. Why is that? Have I taken the wrong? No. Or have I? No. Why is this so thin? What is this? Ah! I have taken the 22. Yeah. Is this? I will. Twenty-two. How can they all be 22? 19, 22. Only one on 19. We do it over again. And there's one in there, and we have, where have we, where is 18, it is there, so there is, I always say method twice and cut one. Today I do it the other way around. Should sit down there and do it. Look through the printer one more time. Ha ha ha! It's just going wrong again. See? But you cannot just shut it off at once. We will not use more time on that tonight. Because then we will start shouting and screaming. It's unbelievable. No matter what I do, set the temperature up, set the temperature down, whatever. It don't help. Good. Tomorrow. I have not really been looking at it today, other than loading a new preset and sometimes I just need time. I don't have. So. I cannot say that this will not stick because it will. machine. If this little printer will work. It's smoking and see? That's fit. It's decided to do it on this instead. Another stick. When I had all the trouble with the heating issue, I loaded reloaded the default preset, and I think I go back to the old one because that one I had tweaked for a long time, so it fits to my needs, and now it do all kind of weird things with the new reload. I think I go back. Thank you. some water. But you can see even with the 25 or 24 more I have, that's not at all enough. It's only a little corner of the, so I need a lot more trees. And I bought 8 meters of this stock today, and now I'm nearly out of it. So we need lots more. And that's why the printer had to run 24/7. Without any hiccups, or too many hiccups. Or else we will never be finished. Because we need near 100 here, at least 400 trees. So that's a lot to print. But we will do it if it needs. And we do need it. I don't see any brown legs anywhere. So I don't. Oh, on the part. Oh, over there. And of course, there comes branches on the side too, but that's you'll do in the other way. But if we don't make the wood dense, then we cannot get the feeling of a big wood and a big forest, and we cannot get the right light down between the trees. We don't have a lot of these. I need a little band sanding machine so I can easier do this. Now we only need 4 or 5 times, that's many. And then we have to come leaves on all of them. can't have in this box. Move them all on the table. The branches, so we have to be careful. Then we will move all of these. Thank you. And then it looks kind of empty here. I'll move them over here later, but not now. Now we will get on where we left yesterday. I will shut the light in there. Kind of dark. Get a new copy. Yes, so gonna need I think and I didn't get my cushions on. I think we have the laptop kind of stops the stream once in a while. I don't know why. It kind of do. So thank you. Then I just it's actually not good when there's no noise in here. Then I'm the only one working. I feel much better when the printer are too. But it has planted a lot of stuff. Maybe it needs a little vacation. Who knows? But we don't have time for that. Vacation stuff. God, I will give it some quality time tomorrow. Let's see. What I can do to get it to work again. Huh. when I'm making these three, I also have to have in consideration the printer, because when these are getting too thin, then there is too much movement up in the top when the printer moves from one to another, and then you have the printers are not getting very good. So you have to, but on the other hand, I don't want them to thick. So it's kind of hitting the spot. That's the goal. And some of the first I made was very thin. Because I didn't really know the printer at that time. And it's ability to cope with that. I also mounted on the, I don't know if you can see that now. No, I have moved the camera. But I have put a tube between the two rods in the top of the printer so that I get more stability when it gets up there, up high in this, because then if it's, and they are going these two rods up in each side, and there is the movement in that, so I have put a rod between the two. Aluminium tube. So I get a little more. And after that the print get cut fine up there. You kind of tweak the printer all the time, so, or over time, so that you, it fits your purpose. Because what I'm doing with it is not necessarily the same that others are doing. I'm sure it isn't, so. They have to tune it to their needs.
Thank you.
It's not always easy to get your big fingers in, but they are actually the best tools if you can get them in. But that's not always possible. Short, but don't matter. Cut it there. And put wood in it. I have something over here. A thick copper wire. Maybe that can do it. I just need a piece. Scratching it too much because then it's not good. See? And then if I take one of these and now we have to be careful because this one also bites. You cannot see what I'm up to. Now you can. I want to make a little tool because I can never get in. It's not anything fancy, but it. Okay. Nah. Seem never to have enough room. Whatever. See? And then if I do this, it gets too clumsy. So I have to use a thinner stick. It was here. Maybe I should have taken a larger piece. I could simply use a grill stick for it, because that is very thin. Like this. And then some other thread. this. It's right here. And then I need to glue it somehow. If we took I know. I should have made it long as this, and then I will make one of these later, but this have to do now. How do I do this? Yes. We will try. This like this. Good luck. Been wet for a minute ago. And now see, this glue always dries when it not have to and not should. Whoops, you just set it there until it kind of, and then we put a thread around it, and then we hope it'll stick. What we will do, I will make a long one, make a long one of this and put it in a stick, because it will be a good tool. And I can make one out to. Is the right size. Yeah. I can make both a big one and a small one. Because all of these tubes I have here, when I try to get in places like this, it's sharpened, and then you need to be able to push in. Now it's difficult to hold this. It's too long. It's really nice. And a little oil on it, and then it will be perfect. But it needs a handle. And you can make one. This is a big circle. You can make one in a very small circle. This is too big to this, for example. So put it to that in your hand. We will make some different sizes. See if this snaps when I touch it. Maybe we should stretch it before we start to wind. So we get a straight thread. Work with. And then we can put some more glue on so we are sure it stands there. Don't hold it. So the other one. So now the tricky bit comes. I'm afraid of touching it. Maybe I should give myself a little more to hold on. I know. So that I don't have to hold everything. Come on. Maybe you should take it a little more down. Afraid of breaking it off before I get it twisted around. It's a little violent. So we'll let this dry a little. So little homemade clay tool. So keep your fingers over it. Until it's dry. We could do that with this one too. And eating oil on our fingers. can smooth it out a little. It's like putting water on your fingers when you are working with real clay. I don't know how good this is for everybody's fingers, because it's kind of real oil, it's not food oil. But I'm afraid of using food oil, because then it will get mold and stuff on it. Right, but I will not try. I guess this is kind of the same type of oil that's in it in the first place. food oil would be good, but it will work as good, I'm sure. But not when it has to stand. Over time, I'm afraid it will get bad. I keep putting my nails in it. Kind of a little rough, not so much in this end. can hear a small plane. So I hope he knows how to fly on his instrument. Because it's dark outside. You don't usually hear small planes this time of night. Not many private airplanes owner have night certificate. Sometimes gone really bad when they have problem figuring out where they are and what's ups and down. It can be a little hairy. And I have to talk them down. Let me try our new tool. Very good. I think that one was kind of where it has to be, but I need to visit the bathroom. guess we can take this one off. And put another one on. And put this repair one on, because that is not as nice anymore as it was once was. It has tumbled a lot of times. And gotten squeezed and whatnot. Every time it has tumbled, I have squeezed it on the middle, so to get it to stand. Stands better while we are working on it. Because it don't stand that well now. Here also some stuff in here we don't want. Work with it without it falling off. think. Give it a little more like this. I think I will make four more of these, and then it's time for some other sorts of trees that are more like. More interesting ones. So when the forest gets a little more interesting, and only these tall, slender ones. So we get a little more Sherwood style. Maybe it's time to have a revisiting to the film Robin Hood in Sherwood. Can always give a little inspiration. Because that's a kind of what we are looking for. But I think that's enough for today. And tomorrow there is another day. And have to make some more trees and whatnot. And I have to get the printer running. That's for sure. So I will say thanks to you for watching and goodbye and good night from here, and see you hopefully again tomorrow. Good night.